Do you want to know how to deal with inputs and outputs in MATLAB? So watch this video. First, we have to define what a string is. A string is a combination of letters, numbers, and special characters. In MATLAB, anything that comes between a pair of single quotations is a string. I type S equals to single quote. This is a string, single quote. This is how you define a string. If you want to display a message or a result, you can use either DISP or a printf function. First, I define a few more variables. To display your result with the DISP function, you just type DISP open parentheses x close parentheses, DISP open parentheses z close parentheses, or DISP open parentheses s close parentheses. If you want the DISP function to display multiple values, you should put all of those values into an array. I type DISP open parentheses open bracket x, y, z close bracket close parentheses, and all three values are displayed. The most common way to use the DISP function is when you want to attach a number to a string. For example, you want to display your result in a meaningful way. Imagine result equals to 15. You want MATLAB to display this message. I type DISP open parentheses open brackets single quote. The result is colon single quote comma result close brackets close parentheses. This actually means I want to display this string and value of this variable together. You see that the value of result variable is not displayed. This is because you cannot simply display a string and a number together. To solve this problem, we should convert the format of our variable to a string using num2str function. Another example. Imagine the distance of a path is calculated as d equals to 16.67. You want to display your result in this way. The distance is colon 16.67 meters. Look what I typed. Notice that we forgot the space between the number and its unit, so I add this extra space. The DISP function is very convenient to use, but it doesn't allow you to display your result in a special format. That's when we need a printf function. To print a string, you simply type fprintf open parentheses s close parentheses, or fprintf open parentheses single quote this is a string single quote close parentheses. But when you want to display this message, you have to do this: fprintf open parentheses single quote the result is colon percent %d single quote comma result close parentheses. This percent %d specifies where your variable is going to be placed, so the value of this variable is going to be put here. Percent %d also specifies the format of displaying your number. Percent %d means display it with a double precision. If your variable is a string, you should use percent %s. For example, name equals to single quote Sarah single quote. I type fprintf open parentheses single quote my name is colon percent %s comma name. The most powerful way of using fprintf is using percent %f format. Then you can display your floating point number with the desired precision. The general syntax is percent %x point y f. Here x is the minimum width of your digits and y is the number of digits that will appear to the right of the decimal point. So percent %6.2f means we have 6 places and 2 of them are going to be to the right of the decimal point. I define a new variable. Area equals to 356.8976. fprintf open parentheses single quote. The area is colon percent %6.2f comma area close parentheses. You see that the value is rounded to the precision of 2 decimal digits. If I change the command in this way, you see all these extra spaces are displayed. One last point regarding fprintf. Unlike the DISP function, fprintf does not print an empty line after running, so you probably would like to add it manually. In order to do this, you should put \n at the end of your string. Now we can display this message. this time using fprintf. fprintf open parenthesis single quote, the distance is colon percent 0.2f meters / n. You see, I didn't specify the width of my number. MATLAB will do it itself. The input command. In order to get the number or a string from the user, you can use the input command. I type age equals to input and I write the message for the user. How old are you? Whatever answer the user responds with is going to be stored in a variable named age. If I ask the user, what is your name? And the answer is, Sarah, I will receive an error. Because by default, it expects me to respond with a number, not a string. I solve it by putting comma s at the end of the command.